The Elephant. The poem The Elephant is written by Herbert Asquith. He was born on 11th March 1881 and died on 5th August 1947. Now let's read the first stanza. Here comes the elephant swaying along with his cargo of children all singing a song. To the tinkle of laughter he goes on his way, and his cargo of children have crowned him with May. In the first stanza, the poet tells us the elephant is moving with some children on his back, and he is moving slowly and in a very rhythmic way. The children on his back are very happy and they are enjoying the ride on the elephant's back. They are singing and laughing, and the children have crowned the elephant, that is, they have made the garland of white flowers which is looking like a crown on his head. Now let's read the second stanza. His legs are in leather and padded his toes. He can root up an oak with a whisk of his nose. With a wave of his trunk and a turn of his chin, he can pull down a house or pick up a pin. Now, in the second stanza, the poet tells us the legs of the elephant is like a leather, as his toes are cushioned with a leather, and the elephant is so strong that he can pull down an oak tree very easily with his strong trunk. Poet further tells us the legs of the elephant are so strong as his toes are cushioned with leather, so he can also pull down a big house with his chin, and the elephant can even pick up a small pin. In this stanza, the poet talks about the strength of the elephant. The elephant is so strong that he can even pull down a big house. Now let's read the third stanza. Beneath his grey forehead, a little eye peers. Of what is he thinking between those wide ears? Of what does he think? If he wished to tease, he could trill his keeper over the trees. Now, in the third stanza, he tells us the elephant's clicking eyes are there below his forehead, and we all know that an elephant is an intelligent animal and he can think very intelligently. He has very big ears. Here, the poet also tells us that the keeper of the elephant, who sits on his back and gives instructions to the elephant, but if the elephant gets angry, he can even throw his keeper over the trees. Now let's read the fourth and the last stanza. If he were not kind, he could play cup and ball with Robert and Helen and Uncle Paul. But that grey forehead, those crinkled ears, have learned to be kind in 100 years. And so, with the children, he goes on his way to the tinkle of laughter and crowned with the May. In the fourth stanza, the poet tells us that his forehead is great and ears are wrinkled in 100 years. He has learned to be very kind with the human beings, and that is why elephant is moving with the children on his back. The children are very happy and they are enjoying sitting on the back. The children are very happy and they have put a garland of white May flowers on his head, which is looking like a crown on his head. In the final and the last stanza, the poet tells us that the children are enjoying the ride on the camel's back. They are enjoying and they are laughing and singing, and they have garlanded the elephant with white flowers, that is, they have made a crown of white flowers.